Hello, hello everyone, and welcome again to another LEGO Barnacle video. For today, guys, here we are going to be reviewing the awesome Matoran of Mata Nui Hali. Now, guys, this is set number 8583, and of course was released in 2003, containing 25 pieces. So, guys, Hali is known as a Gamatoran. Now, a Gamatoran was a specific type, or a different species of Matoran, or kind of like a subcategory of the Matoran, if that's the right way of calling it. Now, of course, this was during the time of the Borok, and of course they took over, blah blah, during kind of also the times of the Toanuvas. Now, what's interesting about Hali, it's just an interesting name, was that she was actually a Matoran who assisted in flax making, but not only that, she was also a participant in the Kolhi Championships, or Kolhi Tournament, if you want to think of it like that. And of course, it's kind of like an annual tournament where the Matorans actually play a game of hockey, practically. So, Kolhi is, of course, the Matoran game, common, and but I just kind of think of it as hockey because it kind of looks like hockey, because she kind of has like a stick there, and she also has a, well, they were given a, kind of like a puck. And of course, what they had to do is, they had to have even teams. I think there were as many teams as they wanted, or I think it was like that. And they would have to obviously score these pucks into the actual goal, simply enough. So a very similar concept to actual hockey. And it was a great sport. Of course, you can be aggressive, push people over, push people. The Matorans could push each other, and that was just kind of the idea. But not only that, guys, she also transformed in what was known as the Toa Inika. Now, I'm sure you guys must know what the Toa Inika are. I wasn't really a big fan of them, in all honesty. I don't know, I just wasn't personally. I didn't really like their build as much, and their shape, as well as their build structure as well. But anyway, other than that, that's what she transformed into, and of course there were six of them, as we all know. Now, she's just one of six. There were the other Matorans as well. There was Maku, which is another set. There was also Hafu, which was also another set. Then you have Huki. Kind of sounds like a Modi name, but Huki. Then you have of course Hali. Then you have Matoro, and you have Kopeki. Now, kind of, you know, Kopeki kind of sounds like Kopaka. So they all kind of had similar names. And it was interesting how, of course, they could transform into these beasts, as we all know. But I wasn't really a fan of the Toa Inika. But anyway, other than that, guys, she is a pretty simple build, as we all know. Only 25 pieces. So if I kind of show you guys, you can see there, you can move the set side to side. Because of the actual gear function here. So this is the actual gear function they used back in 2003. A great gear function, I have to say, of course, giving it some great articulation. And of course, you can actually move the actual arms like so. And commonly used is the Borok arms, kinda. If you can see that there, guys, in the light blue there. Very nice, though. And of course, here is what is known as the Kolhi staff, I think, or the Kolhi, I don't know, Kolhi something. I can't remember the actual name, but I don't know. I think Kolhi stick or Kolhi staff. I can't remember. Anyway, something like that. And it was used, of course. You know, you would just, I don't know how would it work. You kind of get the idea of, like, obviously they would hit it forward, kind of like that. But that's the whole idea. And her cow kind of, you know, Kanohi fell out. But that's that. Let's put it back in. Hopefully it goes back in. Come on, go back in. There we go. So there it is, back on like so. So as we know, guys, this is known as the Kaukau Kanohi, and quite typically worn by Gali, as we all know, Gali Nuva. And yeah, it's quite interesting how she also has the same mask. I don't know why. Is there a reason why they actually have similar masks? Is it because all villagers used to wear them? I can't really remember. Of course, I remember watching the actual movie, The Mask of Light, but I don't really recall as much since it's such an old movie. I really need to rewatch it as well. But as we all know, guys, the actual Kaukau Kanohi can allow the user to breathe underwater, of course, and for regeneration kind of powers as well, because obviously we know Gali Nuva did heal Tahu Nuva from the poison or some sort of control. He was poisoned and controlled at the same time, I think, and that's just kind of the idea of the actual Kanohi. But anyway, other than that, you can't really get any articulation in the actual legs. This is the best you can really do. You can just kind of move it side to side. You can't really move it up and down, if you kind of get what I mean. And pretty small looking feet though, I have to say. Pretty cute though, but very cool indeed. Now, of course, with the actual hands, quite typical and common, of course, with the 2002, 2003, and 2001 set. What did I say like that? 2001, 2, and 3 sets, as we all know, quite commonly these were used as the hands. And yeah, it's quite interesting to be honest. But other than that, of course, the headpiece, of course, follows the same trend from the 2001, 2, and 3 theme. And there it is, like so. So that's the only gear function they actually get with the set. Now, of course, with the actual Kohli, I keep getting it wrong, the Kohli stick or staff, you get this puck as well. Now, of course, you can stick the puck in inside the actual thing, or the you know, the actual Kohli staff or weapon. And I think this kind of works like as a trigger, or does it actually work like a trigger? I don't know exactly if it does, but anyway, of course, you can kind of hold it in place like that and pose her and however you really want to. So kind of like that. And so if I can get her into a position. So I guess kind of like that, if that's the right way of putting it. But yeah, unfortunately you can't really get any articulation in the actual head. That's the sad thing about these sets. But anyway, that's really fine though, to be honest. But that's that pretty much. Now, of course, if I put her right next to her kind of like her partner, I don't know, would you kind of think of her as her partner? But there you can see is, of course, as we all know, Gali Mata, or just Gali from the 2001 release. And there she is, a very great set, of course, very similar, exactly the same. There's the same mask, but of course different build. She's much larger, and she has more articulation and more of a build, as we all know. But I guess I just want to show you a comparison between them, but that's pretty much it. So with that said, guys, I think that's my review pretty much completed on Hahli. And as you know, these actual sets, guys, they were kind of like fill-ins, in all honesty. They were just added in so then people can buy them. Of course, you can collect all 6 of the actual Matorans from, of course, this generation here. Now, I personally only collected one of them. I didn't really see the point of collecting all 6 of them, in all honesty. But of course, there are people out there who really would like to collect them. Then go, you know, by all means, go, guys. I'm sure these are quite easy to find on Bricklink. Very common, very cheap, to be honest. They're not very rare at all. You know, you can find them maybe $3-4, just depending on your currency. But yeah, that's pretty simply I guess it's simple enough, guys. You can just find them Bricklink, and boom, there you have it. Now, of course, with the other sets, such as this one right here. Now, of course, you can see there is Gali Mata, of course, kind of blurred there. Now, these sets are not really hard to find, but they're a bit more pricier. Now, because these are quite retro, unfortunately, having to actually buy these sets, you can get them reasonably cheap, but for a brand new set, you're talking quite a few bucks there, guys. And you know, because obviously with Barnacle having been cancelled, they've just become more expensive, unfortunately, for that reason. Kind of sucks, but that's just kind of the whole idea. But anyway, guys, I really all hope you have enjoyed my review on this set. Of course, I have many more other sets to review and build, of course, guys. So please stay tuned for that. As mentioned, guys, my Brawler Makuta pieces are on the way, so I can't wait to show you that as well. Other reviews, etc., etc., of course, to be done as well. But anyway, guys, have a great day. Please like this video if you have enjoyed it. There's my thumb. Hope you guys will also subscribe to my channel, so then you guys are updated and you guys can see all of my new videos coming out, of course, in the near future. But anyway, guys, as mentioned, have a great day. I will be talking to you all very, very soon. Bye-bye.